Does Chinese medicine have a cure for queefing? The answer may surprise you. Because the answer is actually yes, or at least maybe. And that kind of surprised me. So maybe I should back up and first explain how it is that we got here. Turns out, sometimes when I'm perusing my Nigel Wiseman's Practical Dictionary of Chinese Medicine, I come across an interesting or unusual term which compels me to investigate further. So in this instance, I was actually looking up the term vacuous li, which is a location on the chest or upper abdomen just below the nipple. It's associated with the stomach great luo connecting channel, and it's a place where you can feel the zong qi. But then, suddenly, further down the page, my eye was caught by a most unusual entry titled Vaginal Flatus. So it's not like I was actively researching queefing, or vaginal flatulence, which is apparently the technical term. It was something that just kind of came out of nowhere. It was a bit startling, actually. Anyway, vaginal flatus, or to use a Chinese term, yin chui, is first mentioned in the Jin Gui Yao Lue, and it is the expulsion of qi, or gas, through the vagina. So in American slang, this could be referred to as queefing, or in British slang, this would be called a fanny fart, because in England, fanny actually means vagina. So think about that next time you call this a fanny pack. But a couple of interesting things here. First, this is apparently not just some obscure term that was made up by a no-name doctor. This comes from the Jin Gui Yao Lue by Zhang Zhongjing. Yes, that Zhang Zhongjing. And so, as you probably know, Zhang Zhongjing is probably one of the most famous Chinese physicians. He wrote the Shanghan Zabing Lun around 220 AD, which is divided into two parts. The Shanghan Lun, or Treatise on Cold Damage, and the Jin Gui Yao Lue, Essential Prescriptions from the Golden Cabinet. This second part primarily focuses on herbal formulas for internal conditions, and in it, there's a section titled Miscellaneous Disorders of Women. This is where we get such famous formulas as Gan Mai Da Cao Tang, which is often used as a treatment for postpartum depression, and Jiao Ai Tang, which is the basis for a very famous formula, Si Wu Tang, for substance decoction. And apparently, this is also one of the first mentions of vaginal flatus in Chinese medicine. So, even 2,000 years ago, people were talking about queefing. And another interesting thing here is vaginal flatus is just the translation that Nigel Wiseman chose for the term yin chui. When we actually look at the characters, yin chui, yin just means yin, as in yin and yang. But in this context, we can be pretty sure that it's referring to a region in the lower body. Because sometimes we say things like, the kidney dominates the lower yin orifices, or we use the phrase anterior and posterior yin to refer to the genitals and anus. So even though we literally say yin, we can be pretty sure that it actually means vagina. And then the second character, chui, means to blow, to blast, or to puff. But in its archaic form, it meant to blow specifically as in to blow a flute or to play a musical instrument. So if you ever find yourself experiencing a bout of vaginal flatulence, you can be like, don't mind me, I'm just playing my musical instrument. That's the blowing of my yin flute. So how do we treat vaginal flatus? Well, like most conditions in Chinese medicine, we don't just treat the branch symptoms. Instead, we prefer to do a pattern diagnosis so that we can address the underlying cause. So here it says, vaginal flatus is traditionally attributed to replete grain qi and the downward discharge of stomach qi, or to qi and blood vacuity with center qi fall. So if you encounter vaginal flatus in the wild, there are two possible patterns, a deficiency pattern and an excess pattern. The deficiency pattern is qi and blood vacuity with center qi fall, and the excess pattern is replete grain qi. So the first one is qi and blood vacuity with center qi fall. And here, center qi fall is just the Nigel Wiseman term for what most people would call spleen qi sinking. Remember, one of the functions of the spleen is to raise the clear yang qi, or we could say spleen qi governs upbearing. So if spleen qi is deficient, it fails in its function of lifting and holding things in place, so things can begin to sink downwards. Now, we typically associate this condition with organ prolapse, like uterine prolapse or rectal prolapse. But here, the spleen qi is sinking so much that it sinks down and right out the vagina. And now you're blowing a yin flute. So besides vaginal flatus, for this pattern, we would also expect to see things like shortness of breath, laziness to speak, fatigue, and lack of strength, all indicating deficiency, especially spleen qi deficiency. So normally in this type of situation, we would use the formula Buzhong Yiqi Tong, tonify the middle and augment qi decoction. This formula is basically Sijun Zitong to tonify spleen qi, but then we add in lifting herbs like Huang Qi, Chai Hu, and Sheng Ma to raise up that sinking spleen qi. But in this particular instance, remember that it's not just spleen qi deficiency. It's actually a dual vacuity of qi and blood with spleen qi sinking. So instead, the recommendation is to use Shichuan Dabutong to tonify both qi and blood, and then we add in Chai Hu and Sheng Ma for those lifting properties. So here we have Sijun Zitong to tonify the qi, Si Wu Tong to tonify blood, and Huang Qi, Chai Hu, and Sheng Ma to raise up the sinking qi. For acupuncture, there's no recommendation in the Wiseman book, but we would probably just use points to tonify the spleen, and then add in points like Du 20 to lift things up. And it's kind of funny, while I was looking into this, I realized that Machiocha actually recommends burning moxicones on Du 20 for spleen qi sinking. Which, I don't know, I'm not sure that seems like a good idea. You might just end up with a patient that not only is their uterus prolapsing, but you also just set their hair on fire with moxa. And then for the excess condition, the pattern is replete grain qi with the downward discharge of stomach qi. Now, if you're like me, you've probably never heard of replete grain qi. And it's kind of weird because in the book, this term is in bold, but there's actually no entry in the practical dictionary for replete grain qi. But I'm guessing it's another term for food stagnation or food damage. This is basically you ate too much and the food got stuck. Anyway, in that entry, he says that replete grain qi causes vaginal flatus marked by a loud clear sound and continuous expulsions and is associated with constipation. So here, I'm just imagining a person who's at a big feast and they ate too much and now they have abdominal distension and belching with acid regurgitation, and not only do they have gas, but it's coming out both the back and the front. Or I suppose maybe what's happening is because there's constipation, the large intestine is blocked off, and so the gas can't escape that way. So instead, the qi is forced to go out the anterior yin orifice instead of the posterior yin. And now you have vaginal flatus. But that's just kind of my own guess. Who really knows? So, Nigel Wiseman, if you ever make a third edition of the Practical Dictionary of Chinese Medicine, please include more information about replete grain qi, because we need to know more about vaginal flatus. For treatment of this pattern, he says, treat by moistening dryness and precipitation, And precipitation just means draining downward or using laxatives to induce defecation. And the formula to use is lard and hair brew, gaofajian, which comprises pork lard and hair. So I wasn't able to find out much about this formula or its ingredients. Pork lard is fat or kind of like oil, so I imagine it would lubricate the large intestine to relieve constipation, which goes along with our treatment principle of draining downward. As for the hair, at least in modern times, if we use human hair, we usually use it in its charred form, shui yu tan, and there it's being used to stop bleeding. But we also note that it does have an ability to resolve stasis, so maybe that's why it's being used here, to break up some stasis. So I guess that if you ever find yourself in a situation where you ate so much food that you begin farting out the front, maybe try eating pork lard and hair. Now, just to be clear, this is all meant to be in good fun. I just thought it would be amusing to try to explain an unusual term that I found in a book. In reality, expulsion of air through the vagina is completely normal and common. It can happen due to exercise, sexual activity, or even just inserting a tampon. So it's usually harmless and does not require treatment. However, there are some instances where it can be caused by weak pelvic floor muscles. This can happen especially after childbirth and is also associated with organ prolapse. So that's probably what Zhang Zhongjing was referring to with this pattern of qi and blood deficiency with spleen qi sinking. So if you have a patient who experiences excessive vaginal flatulence after giving birth, this might be something to consider. In other, and I think rare situations, this can also be caused by a vaginal fistula. This is an abnormal opening between the vagina and some other organ, such as the large intestine. And so given that, it's kind of interesting to note that for shui yu tan, it's also said, it likewise excels at treating foul-smelling blood in the stool due to necrosis in the bowel. And so maybe necrosis in the bowel is similar enough to a colovaginal fistula that's kind of what we were talking about with that second pattern, and maybe that's why it uses hair. But again, the vast majority of the time, expelling air through the vagina is considered completely normal, very common, and does not require any medical intervention. I just thought it would be kind of fun to talk about. And if you want to learn more fun facts about Chinese medicine, go sign up for my newsletter, Daily Acupuncture Facts. Every day, you'll receive an email with a fun fact about an acupuncture point, and then at the end of each week, there's a quiz that you can take to review everything that you've learned. This is great for students who are studying acupuncture points, but I've also had a lot of practitioners who really enjoy getting these emails every day, and it kind of reminds them of things that they may have forgotten over time. So go sign up. There's a link in the description below. And if you want to watch more videos about Chinese medicine, the YouTube algorithm thinks you'll like this one, or you can stick around and look at pictures of my cat. Either way, I'll see you next time.